until about 100 years ago, people did before they went to sleep. Well, today it's a little less romantic because we usually just switch off our smartphones. But beyond this, the artificial light that smartphone screens produce might actually have an effect on sleep. And this is what my research is about. Now, you might ask yourself, why should that actually be the case? What we have to know is that inside our brains, a tiny clock is ticking. And it stays synchronized with the environment, with our watches, so to speak, by tracking changes in the light in the environment, from dawn via bright midday light with a lot of blue light to dusk. Now, the crucial thing is that also the screens from your smartphones, for example, as any other modern screen, produces quite a lot of blue light, thereby constantly telling your brain to stay awake and not to prepare for sleep. Thereby, it may also have detrimental effects on your sleep, and that is actually quite well established by now. Now, as scientists, we always want to know things in more detail. So at the Psychiatric University Clinic, actually, we ask ourselves what happens in the brain, and we look at brain waves. Now, that is a little more complicated concept, so let me illustrate this for you. If you imagine the brain to be an orchestra, then the brain waves sort of reflect the music or the concert it plays. And that allows us to, at any moment during the night, determine how deep someone is sleeping and also judge the overall quality of sleep. By now, what we already know is that artificial light is indeed able to change that nocturnal concert of your brain, as if it was suddenly playing modern music instead of Mozart. But the questions we ask now is, what exactly is changing there? Because that is until now unknown. So what we ask is, maybe perhaps it's the conductor who's furious, and therefore the music changes. Or it's again the violins who didn't practice. Or the orchestra is actually trying to play Mozart, but they just had a drink too much before the rehearsal. So these are the questions we are trying to answer, and thereby we hope that one day we will be able to develop protective approaches which might not only apply to modern screens, but also might be important for people who have to stay awake during the night because they have to work. So, To sum up, what I've told you is that blue light can be detrimental for your sleep. From all what science suggests until now, I can recommend you to prefer a paper-based book to checking the latest tweets and Facebook messages on your phone when you want to have a good night of sleep. All that's left to say, sleep well, but only later.